back to Vlogmas. For today's video, I am sharing with you all of my empties of the year 20. I don't want to say 2021 because beech mein bhi ek empties kiya tha na. So this is like half of 2021. Wo last video ke baad jitna bhi mere products khatam hue, sab maine dabbe mein collect kiya hai. I have a big fat box over here. It has makeup, it has skincare and what not. I've decluttered from the last video. If you remember when I gave you all the vanity tour, we decluttered everything at the back. So everything is there. With this video, of course, I'm going to share with you all what I would purchase, what I loved so much so that I would repurchase. So you will get a lot of recommendations there and what is like literally not good and I'm never going to repurchase as well. So there will be mini reviews attached. As well as at the end of today's video, I'm doing my first giveaway for Vlogmas 2021. All the rules for that will be mentioned at the end of the video. So stay tuned till then. But now without any further ado, we can dive straight into this. If this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. Take a moment, hit that subscribe button, join the Sarah squad. I'm sure you'll love it here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, we can dive straight into this. Okay, dabba is in my lap. Let's first start with what I can see on the top and what I keep repurchasing and absolutely love, and that is the Fiamma Deville's body washes. These are so good for the value of money I pay for this, because like 500 ml costs me 400 bucks and there's always some or the other discount on this on Amazon. I tend to order a lot of my like body care products on Amazon and refills on Amazon. I have tried so many variants in them, but my favorite is this one. This is the blackcurrant and burberry one. I have now a new fresh bottle already in my bathroom ready to use. Still have a little bit left over here. I will try to finish this as well. And I've used also the lemongrass and jojoba variant. Now this one is more fresh, so I will tend to repurchase this and the baby pink one in the summers. And this is very less, this is all season. I love the fragrance of this for all seasons. It's very nourishing, hydrating, cleanses your body, does the job. It's very very cheap is why I love buying it. It's good and it's cheap. And what else can I want from a body wash? Because I'm big and tall and I need a lot of products. So that's perfect for me. Next, let's dive in for another favorite that I keep repurchasing. And that's the Garnier Micellar Water. I don't know why it's foaming up so much right now. I travel with this. I love the big bottle because again, it's more economical to buy the big bottle. I feel like travel size variants are a lot of waste of money. So I tend to just keep repurchasing the bigger bottles. Love this one. Love the yellow one also in this. And I think now they have a new vitamin C one, which I'm yet to try, but love the micellar waters that Garnier does. It takes off your makeup super easy. You just need to drench one cotton pad completely, and my base makeup is off, and in the other cotton pad my eye makeup is off. So it's fast, does the job, is affordable. Highly recommend this one. When it comes to removing my makeup, I've also used two of my cleansing balms right here. This is the Clinique Take the Day Off balm. Very highly raved about, and so true to its rave, because it is 100% worth the money. I definitely do want to repurchase actually the bigger size of this because I got the travel size in one of those kits. I purchased this for myself. I also got myself the makeup remover, which is not here. Was it in my last empties, or maybe I've just misplaced that bottle? But the liquid makeup remover is also very good. It's absolutely brilliant. I would say so much so that it's better than the Garnier micellar water. Of course, it's even more expensive and that tends to get over much faster. So that I might not repurchase because it's a little too expensive to keep rebuying. But this one goes a very long way. Like I bought this Dibbi somewhere around 7 to 8 months back, and trust me, I use makeup a lot, so it has lasted me so long. You need very less product. It just emulsifies your makeup, melts it. Like thoda sa use karoge na to bhi full face of makeup melts easily, and it cleanses your like skin very deeply, so you don't have to use a lot of micellar water after you use the Take the Day Off balm. So I definitely think it's worth every single penny you pay for this. Another very good balm that I've completely used up is the Earth Rhythm Propolis cleansing balm. Thoda sa bacha hai, like about two of my more makeup applications will get cleansed with this much balm. But again, brilliant. It emulsifies makeup so well. It's literally a dupe of the Clinique Take the Day Off balm, because this is half the money, but it does the job beautifully. Used up so much sunscreen. Of course, you know how integral sunscreen is a part of my life, because I use a lot of actives on my skin. And just in general, I keep promoting this, that please use your sunscreen even when you're at home. And no matter what you apply on your skin, active or no active in your skincare routine, sunscreen is a must. I've gone through so many different brands and tubes. So first I'm going to talk about the Bubble Farm Ultra Light Daily Sun Shield. Now this is a hydrating sunscreen. This is SPF 40. and it protects against UVA, UVB both. Really like this one. Also, it's a glass bottle, so it's difficult to travel with, but I've used it till the very, very end. Even lost the cap that came on this pump. Bahut acha sunscreen, especially in the winters now. You will love this one because it's hydrating. There's no white cast whatsoever. Hydrating, not in a way that it's going to feel heavy on your skin. It sinks right in, but it has a moisturizing sort of a texture. So I really, really like this one. I would repurchase this, but this would be something that I would just keep in my drawer and not travel around with. For traveling around, I love squeezy tubes because they are very handy. One of them that I've used up is the LA Shield Fisco Matte Sunscreen Gel. Now, this one I don't like itna zyada. Also, SPF on this is not mentioned, so I don't know how much is the sun protection, but I don't like this because there's slight amount of white cast to it. So if I'm applying makeup and all, there's some flashback when I'm taking photos, so I don't enjoy that a lot. Plus, because it's water resistant, it's slightly greasier on the texture side, so I don't thoroughly enjoy the texture of the LA Shield sunscreen. So I can like skip that because I love the next one that I'm going to talk about. This has been an OG since I was in college, and this is a Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunblock. This is also SPF 50. Very good value for money for like 700 something, and even on discount it gets cheaper. You get like 88 ml product. So if you're looking for something more on the inexpensive side, even if you want to try this one, I know it comes in like travel size variants. So for college girls and whoever wants to be more on a budget but still get good sun protection, y'all can definitely try this out. I used it when I was in college and it helped me so much when I should travel by train and everything. But these days, what I love, love, love using and keep buying refills of is the UV Duo SPF 50. My dermat introduced me to this, and this is such a good sunscreen. It's completely matte. It's like a silicone-based texture, and it sinks right into your skin. Like, you don't feel this at all, and where I like it is underneath makeup because it doesn't change the way my skin feels because of the sunscreen. So I'm getting sun protection, but at the same time, my skin is not greasy, not oily, and it's very minimal white cast with this, and sun protection is maximum. Used two tubes completely and have another 100 gram in my jar. It's slightly on the expensive side. The 100 gram tube costs about $1,000, so it's slightly expensive. And with sunscreen, I can't tell you, little goes a long way. You should use more and more sunscreen. Like, at least itna to sunscreen use karna chahiye for the complete face to be covered. And so if you want to go for more economical options, I've mentioned the entire variety and list to you. I will try to leave all the links as well in the description box for you to check out. There's also this cool feature that YouTube has that has a product section over here. So if you can just tap on that, you will get a list of all the products I can list for you over there. So I'll try to do that as well. Next, I got done with this Too Cool for School Egg Mellow Body Butter. It was such a yummy body butter. Honestly, like, I have scraped out every single part of this. It was so, so delicious. Like, literally, I should feel like eating it more than applying it because I loved it. And ye tha na, isliye I was more motivated to moisturize my body because sometimes I get damn lazy with putting body lotion because I have a very big body and it's a task all in itself. But it is so, so, so good. But so expensive for a body butter. It costs about ₹1,000. I think it was like 1100 or 1000 rupees for this. I got this on Limes Connect, and I have a discount code with Limes Connect. You can use the code SARA10 and you'll get some discount, 10% off on Limes Connect. So I did buy this. This didn't even come as PR because I was very intrigued by the packaging and everything that this brand had to offer. It's very cool and unique and not something that's already on the market. And the texture of this body butter is not something like, you know, like a Bath and Body Works. I tell you, you buy it for the fragrance, you buy it for the experience. It's expensive because of the experience that Bath and Body Works gives. It's not that moisturizing. I feel like all of their body lotions are the same texture. Khali wo fragrance badal dete hai. But isme the body butter is good. Like, the content, the texture, the hydration, and the lasting, it's so different now, the texture of this. Like, I apply it, I feel like it's nice, creamy, mousse-like. But then it sinks in and I don't feel it at all on my body, but it still moisturizes for very long hours. Like, the next day also, I'll not feel the need to reapply a body lotion or a body butter. So I definitely recommend this. If you're looking for a good one, don't mind spending that kind of money, then definitely try this out. Ran out of my OG since literally a year and a half. I love this serum so much. I already have a refill in my jar. This is the L'Oreal Extraordinary Oil Serum. This is such a great, great, great hair serum. It also acts as a heat protectant for me. I only use this on the go, even traveling with this, even though it's difficult to travel with it because it's heavy, but I still choose to travel with this because it's so bloody good. It's really a good serum. There's nothing else to say. It's not even that expensive. 500 and lasts you about 3 months. Aram se. After every hair wash I use this, and before straightening my hair also I use this. So highly recommend this one also. My curling cream was over, but I've cut it to use till the very end and scraped out all the edges of my curling cream. Brand new tube, already the refill is over here. This is a Curl Up Curl Defining Curling Cream for frizzy, wavy and curly hair. You can see I have very frizzy hair, even though I straightened it yesterday. Wo kaafi jaldi frizz ho jata hai. So when I wash my hair and the days I'm not straightening it for videos or anything, then I tend to use a ton of curling cream and scrunch it up, and this is so good. Even though my hair is quite damaged with all the heat treatment, this curling cream keeps my curls intact and looks good even when I'm not straightening my hair. So it's not like my hair is like a frizzy mess when I'm not straightening it out. So this curling cream is definitely a must have. Highly recommend. This is my third tube of the same, and I refrain to like switch my curling cream because this is so good. Alright, now we're down to the makeup section. There's very little makeup products. Of course, itna jaldi makeup khatam nahi hota. The first product I have is the Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. Very little of this is left. Of course, I'm going to use it till the very end because this in India is like 1,000 rupees. If you have anybody traveling internationally, definitely get it from there because it's not sasta udhar, but idhar pata nahi customers se laga ke 1,000 rupees ka hai, but definitely worth it. I got mine on HOK makeup because they have some crazy offers on that website. But so good. This is really good makeup setting spray. I would give this like a little higher rating than even the MAC Fix Plus. It's really that good. Highly recommend. Definitely gonna repurchase. Gonna wait till like that much also gets over and then repurchase mine. Another base product I ran out of is the Chambord Geneva Anti-Shine Primer. This, if you're an OG, you know, this was literally one of my first PRs ever from an Indian like PR agency that sent me PR, and I used this primer till the very end. Like abhi bhi if I squeeze out na thoda product to pakka niklega isme se. Aadhi to hawa hai but thoda to product definitely hai isme, and this is such a good primer, you guys. I love Chambord. I've loved Chambord even before I got PR from them. I've never worked with the brand as such, but this is a very good primer. मैंने बहुत लंबा इसको चलाया है. Highly recommend this primer. It's very good for like filling your pores and everything. I wouldn't repurchase because currently I'm using a couple of other good primers that I'm also trying out, and I like to keep switching up my makeup, so I refrain from rebuying the same things unless they like literally blow my mind away. But if you're looking for a good primer, I definitely recommend this one. I have two concealers right here. The Pat Take Cover Concealer. You already know I have purchased a fresh one of this in my Nykaa haul. This is in the shade Birthday Suit. It suits me so well. The color matches me perfectly, and this concealer blends in like a dream. Like, I love the coverage on this. It's medium to full also if you want to build it up, and it blends very easily. So it's a very good concealer on the go, or even if you want to wear for like flash photography, weddings and stuff. Very versatile and very affordable also. Like $3.95 for this is definitely worth it. And another concealer, which is again from the affordable section, again already purchased in the Nykaa haul, so you must have seen, this is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer. Definitely a tried and trusted. Highly recommend. I'm in the shade medium deep tawny, I think. Yeah, medium deep tan is my shade in this. There are two mediums, that's why I'm mentioning the deep tan also. Love the applicator. The only thing is it has like a paint thinner kind of smell to it. So iska fragrance, even the foundation has that kind of fragrance to it. I've not tried the foundation though on this, but the concealer is very good. Highly recommend this. Last couple of products, I have the NYX Vivid Brights Eyeliners. Now I love these because they're so fun and colorful and very good actually. Formula wise, the liquid is very pigmented and it glides on very easily on the eyes. I have the shade lavender and blue, but just the idea of not using them enough, ye bahut jaldi sook jati hai. Like within 6 months, my lavender to dried out within 3 months only, and the blue one lasted me about 6 months and then it dried out, and I was so disappointed because by the time I think, oh, let me switch off my makeup look and I go and try to use it, this product has already dried up. So it's very sad like that. But I think Anu told you can use that, right?
Yeah.
So I'm not gonna get rid of this. You get Inglot's, what is that? Inglot ka Duraline. So you can use Inglot ka Duraline, which is basically this product. It's like an oily thing. If you put it inside, toh jo bhi sook jata hai, it becomes wet again. So you can start using your eyeliners again. Lipsticks, I don't think are completely over, but definitely expired 100%. और काफी मतलब खत्म भी हो गई. दीज वर माय मॉम्स फेवरेट्स. दिस इज द शेड मरून मिक्स. दिस इज द लैक्मे 9 to 5 प्राइमर प्लस मैट लिपस्टिक. दिस वाज ऑल द रेज बैक इन द डे व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड यूट्यूब. सो आई हैड सो मेनी इन दिस शेड. एंड दिस इज द शेड मेपल मैप. एंड मेपल मैप वाज अ कल्ट फेवरेट. इफ यू पिक अप एनी ऑफ माय ओल्ड लिपस्टिक वीडियोस, यू विल सी दिस लिपस्टिक ओवर देयर. And this was so, so good. Everybody, you should love Maple Map on me. And Maroon Mix was my mom's favorite. Both these lipsticks are still very much a recommendation. Of course, you've seen my lipstick draw. You know I don't need any more lipsticks. But if you're looking for a good nude and a good maroon shade lipstick, these lipsticks last very long as well. Like, they're hydrating and they last long. Like, look at Maple Map. It's like this nice, yummy coffee meets gingerbread biscuit kind of nude. And Maroon Mix is like typical mama shade. Berry toned, pinky, and more pinky than berry toned. So again, very good formula, hydrating, lasts long enough, like 6 hours. That's good for a bullet lipstick and is also affordable. Like, these go on discount and cost you like $300. So highly recommend this. I also got done, actually finished the entire ColourPop X I Love Sarahi liquid lip. This is the matte lip in the shade Softy. I loved this color so much when I was in college. Every time I would have to put on lipstick, I would put on this one because it's a dark brown. So it would suit me even bare skin without any makeup on whatsoever. Loved this lipstick. Love ColourPop formulations, but I know it's difficult to get them in India. You can get it on international makeup pages, but then it loses the charm of being ColourPop and being affordable. So then what's the point? But yeah, that is it for everything that I've emptied in the year 2021. I mean, naya saal, naye products, and nayi cheeze khatam hogi. I'm so excited when things get over because I'm getting my full value's worth once I finish a product. And now it's time for the rules of today's giveaway. It's the first giveaway of Vlogmas. This year is super special. You know, this year's Vlogmas has a lot to do with Impulse Coffees because I told you about Impulse literally in this year's Vlogmas. Whoever wins today's giveaway will be getting all of these products and also one Impulse Coffee's flavor bottle. The rules of the giveaway are super simple. First, you have to be subscribed to my channel. Of course, I'm hoping that if you're here, you're subscribed to my channel, but also be subscribed to Impulse Coffee's YouTube channel. Follow both I and Impulse Coffee's on our Instagrams, and also leave a comment down below and let me know which is the product that you get over with sabse jaldi. Kaun sa product aapke vanity mein, aapke beauty and स्किनकेयर में सबसे जल्दी खत्म हो जाता है. अलॉन्ग विद दैट, इफ यू डोंट हैव एन इंस्टाग्राम, देन जस्ट मेंशन योर ईमेल एड्रेस इन योर कमेंट और मेंशन योर इंस्टाग्राम हैंडल व्हाटएवर, सो दैट आई कैन लुक बैक एंड चेक इफ यू आर फॉलोइंग ऑल द रूल्स. दैट इज इट, सुपर सिंपल रूल्स. आई विल आल्सो मेंशन द रूल्स इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स फॉर यू. थैंक यू सो मच यू गाइस फॉर वॉचिंग. आई विल सी यू इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो टुमारो. बाय गाइस, लव यू.